Hey guys, welcome to another computer graphics tutorial. Today we'll be learning about cathode ray tube, a tutorial by QuickCS. So CRT display techniques. A CRT monitor displays color pictures by using combination of phosphors that emit different colored lights. By combining the emitted lights from the different phosphors, a wide range of colors can be generated. There are two basic techniques for producing color displays with a CRT. First one is called beam penetration method and second one is called shadow mask method. So first we'll learn about beam penetration method. The beam penetration method for displaying color pictures has been used with random scan monitors. Two layers of phosphor, usually red and green, are coated onto the inside of the CRT screen. And the displayed color depends on how far the electron beam penetrates into the phosphor layer. So if you don't know what random scan monitor is, I have made a separate video on random scan monitor. I'll provide you guys with the link in the description below. A beam of slow electrons excites only the outer red layer. A beam of very fast electron penetrates through the red layer and excites the inner very layer. So what happens if the electron beam is fast? It penetrates more deep and it excites the inner green layer. An intermediate beam speeds. Combination of red and green light are emitted to show two additional colors, orange and yellow. So basically, if the electron beam is the fastest, then it will emit or excite green color, so the screen will emit green color. If it is too slow, it will excite only the outer red layer, so it will show red color. But if the speeds are intermediate, then it can show two different colors, orange and yellow, depending on the screen. The speed of electrons and hence the screen color at any point is controlled by the beam acceleration voltage. Okay, so basically beam acceleration voltage decides the speed of the electrons and the speed of the electron decides how deep the electrons penetrate into the two layers of phosphor, and on depending on which layer it is exciting, the color is emitted. So this is beam penetration method. It is used in random scan monitors. Okay. The next one is shadow mask display. Shadow mask methods are commonly used in raster scan display. I have made also a video on raster scan systems. You can check it out, including color TV. So color TV is of raster scan display type, as they produce a much bigger range of color than a beam penetration method. Of course, you don't want to see a television which can just show red, green, orange and yellow color, right? So that's why we use raster scan system, which has a wide range of colors. A shadow mask CRT has three phosphor color dots at each pixel position. One phosphor dot emits a red light, another emits a green light, and the third emits blue light. Okay. Shadow mask display CRT has three electron guns, one for each color dot, and a shadow mask grid just behind the phosphor coated screen. So basically, there are three electron guns emitting three different colors, R, G, B, that is red, green, and blue. And each pixel position also has three different color dots. Okay, red, green and blue. So this is how the structure of the shadow mask CRT looks. Okay, so basically these are the three electron guns, red, blue and green. This is the shadow mask. What does shadow mask do? Shadow mask takes this electron beams, all the three electron beams, and positions them properly according to the picture. Okay, so this is the pixel position. This is just the magnified view of the pixel position. So you have red dot over here, you have blue dot over here, you have green dot over here. But they are placed so close that it looks like a combination of all three colors, depending on which three colors are visible in how much value. Okay, and this is the phosphor-coated screen. This is the operation of shadow mask CRT. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you like this video, please make sure that you subscribe to our channel, like and share this video with your friends. And please, if you have any doubt, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. Thank you.